Hello Golfhub. Alright, so now part two of the ball testing review. We've come down to the third at Wingate, so I'm going to show you guys the board here. I'm going to be judging this as more or less distance on based on these numbers here. I'm going to be hitting from the championship tee, which is about 30 meters back from the standard tee. So to hit the bunker on the left, I would have to be driving 250, 260, and the one on the right, it's about a 270. So my average drive is approximately 260. So I've got a good gauge on, you know, what kind of distance I get going on the two bunkers here from this tee position. So yeah, gonna give it a feel, tell you what it feels like off the face, give you an idea of perceived spin. Again, this is not with a GC2, we're in the process of getting one. So this is just a subjective hacker's guide to balls and what they feel like off the driver. Alright, Bridgestone balls. I'm gonna go in the same order that I went with in the irons. Again, my driver swing is not great at the moment, so I'm just trying to do as best I can and give you guys an idea for feel. First one up is the E7. This one, I imagine, is the distance one. These Bridgestones have got that funny dimpled pattern, so let's see if it actually does anything in the wind. You know, reduces a bit of drag. That was a poor strike. I'll tell you what, still gone about 240, which again for me, you can see the strike there. That was very bad. So yeah, not my best. These Bridgestones, for some reason, I don't hit them well. Alright, E6 Bridgestone. Let's give it a smack. Same principle, I think, just a little bit more spin, I suppose, in this one. Alright, dead straight down the middle, no draw, no fade. Felt quite hard off the face, didn't strike it too badly. There's the contact right there. Distance wise, 260, so nothing special, nothing wild. But I imagine they're a cheaper ball, so it's not a bad one. Alright, the E5. This one's got that interesting groove or dimple pattern again, so hopefully I can put a good swing on this one and actually feel the dimples at work. Got a hold of that one. Distance wise, sadly, not that much. Straight out of the middle, the contact, but it just didn't fly. So that was disappointing. I was hoping for a lot more out of that one. Bridgestone Fix. This is the one that got one of the best results in the irons in terms of the distance to the pin from the shot, and it gave me a very low ball flight with iron, so I'm quite curious to see what it does with the driver. I got hold of that one as well. That has gone not that far, actually. About 260, straight out of the middle. It felt good off the face, actually, but just not traveling. Keeping in mind, whilst doing this test, it is about 4-ish in the afternoon now, so it could also be cold air that is preventing the ball from flying, but we're testing all the balls at the same time, so you know, if it is flying less, it's going to fly less for everything. Now the B330 Tour, the big tour inspired, more expensive ball in the Bridgestone lineup. Let's see how this one goes. Oh,
very good feel of the face. It felt like it popped. Distance wise, 265, 270. So also not hugely long. Got a decent strike on it. Not a bad ball. Not massive distance, but not a bad ball. It doesn't have a very loud clack off the face either, which is quite nice. And the last one in the Bridgestone series, the B330S. So the way I perceived this one the last time was that it was a bit harder, similar to what the Pro V1X and the Z-Star XV would be. So in theory, this one should go 5 meters further, assuming I put a half decent strike on it. Cutting a bit, can't really gauge. I know I saw it line. Yeah, okay, so it's about 275, so it did get a bit of extra distance. Wasn't my best strike though, had a biggish cut on that one. So yeah, all in all, out of the Bridgestones, I still think that fix is the best one. If I compare it to, you know, if I summarize between irons and teebox shots. Okay, so a little bonus clip that I'm going to give you guys. My driver, as you guys know, is a 765 bonded edition, 8.5 degree. And the Tour AD, I think it's 60 gram stiff shaft. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and, or rather, yeah, let's say try, attempt to hit the ball off the deck. I'm about 240 away at Wingate. It is quite painful actually doing this to my driver, but in the interest of entertaining you guys, I will be doing attempting this. So the three balls that I've selected is two of the Nikes, because I think it's no secret that I don't like the Nike balls, and the Noodle because it's the cheapest one that I've got. So yeah, let us see if I can do that Sergio Garcia magic. The green, I don't know if you guys can see it there, but the green is about, I reckon, 230 carry. There's a little stream right in front of the green. Yeah, no idea what to expect, but let's just give it a bash. Oh my goodness, that's so good. I'm exceptionally lazy, I don't feel like walking up there now, but that is so good. That's on the green. Second one, the Noodle. Same concept, off the fairway. So yeah, final ball. Nike 20XI. This is probably the most hated ball that I tested. Let's see if it can win back some sort of good favor with me.